co-main event of the evening. Corey Pavao in the blue corner, Michael Larrimore in the red.
More bantamweight action as they get right into it.
Big slam coming up.
Oh
my goodness.
He jumped into that one there.
He jumped into the swimming pool on him. Larrimore jumping guillotine.
Yeah, Larrimore stands up and jumps for his guillotine of his own there.
Pavao drags him back down.
Yeah, and this is just the first minute into it. So a lot of, you know, muscles, biceps engaging, taking down, slam it, and then the person getting right back up and taking him down again. And it's just 1 minute in.
Corey Pavao says he just loves the grind, the mental grind of training and fighting. And just loves the competition.
Yeah, he's definitely grinding on it.
Doing work here on the back of Michael Larrimore.
Looks like Pitt was trying to reach in that choke.
Got that body triangle.
Yeah, a body triangle is very, not only you're securing position on a person's back, but you're also squeezing in that lower abdominal region, kind of making it difficult for the person to breathe.
Rolls over, this is not much better. Oh, he's gonna look to flatten him out. Okay, he is a little high.
Stand up transition from the body lock and just put those hooks in. And then push your hips in to get Larrimore back down.
And reverses.
Now, yeah, reverses.
Good work. We're going to have rubber guard. Oh, Larrimore pops out.
His back here. He spent most of the round on top, and Larrimore was on his back. Now Pavao trying to fight from this back position here. And it's just under a minute left. You really want to see Pavao fight to get his way back up. You don't want that last 3 minutes where you're in control to escape. You know, these judges, some of these judges here have short-term memory. So yeah, you spent 3 minutes in a dominant position on top. But this last minute here, Larrimore was able to maintain control in the top position.
Yeah.
last 10 seconds. Looks like they're just going to finish this one out here. And that's it. This second round, I was just about to say, Larrimore is content with keeping it up on the feet with those chopping down with those leg kicks and demonstrating, showing off some of his striking here. Pavo didn't like that, so he engaged now here with this body lock into a takedown, just like he spent most of the first round here. There's not enough urgency here out of Larrimore. If I'm in his court, I'm yelling at him, get up, get up. He had success in the first 30 seconds of this round with those outside kicks and those strikes with the hands. But Paul wouldn't like it, so he took him down. There we go, a little bit of urgency for him to get up. But you don't just want to land and just allow this person in a mounted position on top of you. Calvin used to frame off and land some punches, land some elbows. I would like to see more action out of both of these guys, whether they're on the bottom or on top. Take a page out of, you know, George Bergala's book and John Arch. They were, you know, striking from the top, from the bottom, from all positions.
Oh. Cup popped out.
And he got
and there's the tap.
There's the tap.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, the referee calls a stop to this bout at 2 minutes and 5 seconds. Your winner with the rear naked choke, Corey Pavao.